Hello and welcome to 9design 3D. Today we will make this snowy, especially snowfall, thunder scene in this video. Let's go to the tutorial. First, we will add a plane for our scene because we made a road. After you select your camera angle, we will add an array modifier for our plane. Set your X 0 and Y value 1. Now you can increase your count in array modifier. After all of that, we will Shift D to duplicate it for the sidewalks and G to move your sidewalks part. In Tap to Edit mode, you can choose this edge line and E to extrude down. Choose this edge line again, Ctrl B to bevel. With the middle mouse button, you can increase your segments, Shade Smooth and Auto Smooth. And after all of that, again we will Shift it to duplicate it for the middle part of sidewalks. As the same method, we will choose this edge line and E to extrude down. Ctrl B to bevel again. For the other sidewalks and roads, we will continue to Shift it to duplicate it and place it for our scene. Again, Ctrl B to bevel. Before all of this, go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons and type Sapling Tree again. We will make a tree for our scene. With Shift A, under the curve Sapling Tree gen, you can select it. From the middle menu, left part, you can choose your branch radius, leaves, their ratios, scales and types. From the branch splitting, as you see, you can increase your levels for making huge trees, or base your splits for the different part of and different angle of your branches. Under the leaves, you can check the show leaves. As you see, you can choose your leaf type from here too. Again, turn back to geometry. Under the load preset, as you see, some willow, small pine or small maple type of trees in here. You can choose which type tree you want to add your scene. You can set them in here. I will add this type of tree and I will add some leaf in here. And I'm adding them collection with M. After all of that, along the road, I will Shift it to duplicate my trees and place them near the sidewalks. You can give different shapes with the scale, or if you want, you can rotate them. For the middle part of it, I am adding this type of little small pines in here. Now we will add a cylinder because we want to model this time our own street lamp. Add a cylinder, scale and place it. In Tap to Edit mode, from the top face, you can G to move it and make it taller. Shift it to duplicate this and scale place your street lamp second part. For the third part, I will add a cube in here and I will scale it and place it in here. From the under face, you can choose this, press I to inset, E to extrude up. Scale it again, I to inset and E to extrude down. It's filled with this type of shape. We will add some subdivision surface modifier. You can shade smooth it or increase your level viewport too. And in Tap to Edit mode, you can add some loop cuts for giving which shape you want, you can add it. I am Ctrl J to join them together with applying my modifier, and as the same method, you can add some array modifier. Set your X 0 and with the Y value, you can increase it randomly. And with the count, you can increase it. After that, Shift it to duplicate for the other sidewalk. For the middle of it, you can Shift them together and add. Under the Edit, Preferences and Add-ons, I will add some landscape for my sidewalks back. Under the mesh, you can add some landscape in here. From the left middle menu, under the operate settings, you can set type of your terrain. For example, if you want, you can get some cliff, canyon, mesa or mountains, which type you want. I will make a bit little hills around my sidewalks because I want to make full of my scene, but as usually we will add some fog and they won't look too much. I choose this type and I am increasing my random seeds. With the scaling or effect type, under of it you can change it. With the offsets and size, give which type shape you want. I am scaling it with the huge. Along the row, I am shifted to duplicate for the other parts too. And with the scaling in z-axis, you can make it very little. I shifted to duplicate it for the other side. Let's add a plane again because we will add some snow particles in here. We want some snowfall. After adding your plane, we will add some particle system with the plus icon. Under the emitter, we will use this. When you press space, as you see in the timeline, they will drop it like that. Under all of it, you can set your lifetime. It's a high value. And the end time, frame end, you can match your timeline and frame end from here. Frame start, I will make negative value because when I start the animation, I want to see still falling. Under the number, you can increase it. Under the velocity, bring normal value to 0. And you randomize, you can set it because they can be complex falling, as you see. And the fill weights, you can set your gravity how you want. When you get it 0, it won't fall anymore. But if you give some gravity value high, it will start to falling now with the slowly. And I want to add some icospheres for my scene because they will drop it. In the edit mode with auto proportional edit and middle mouse mid-size, you can middle mouse button, you can scale and place it and give a bit of natural shape with changing some part of your vertices. I will shift it to duplicate it again. Choose all of them, press M and add them in a new collection. I'm adding a snowball collection. Under the render, in the particle, you can choose render as collection and instance collection, choose your snowballs. And now, as you see, our snowballs and icospheres will falling down. Under the render scale, you can give some scale value and scale randomness, it will make the height to randomize. I will add force field as a wind because I want to make some a bit thunder look. You can move it. And under the settings from the right menu, you can change your strength. As you see, it will falling down for the side. Let's add some material in here. For the roads, we will add a material. After that, go to shading tab. And we will mix up some materials. I showed before, you can go from the top right card how to mix your materials quickly. I downloaded this asphalt material from here, ambientcg.com, and I downloaded the snow material, and for the sidewalks I downloaded this concrete material. First go to edit preferences add-ons and type node wrangler. We want to mix our some other textures with the mix shader. Add a mix shader between material output and principal BSDF. After that, shift it to duplicate your first principal BSDF and connect this BSDF for the shader nodes too. Choose this first, press Ctrl+Shift+T and after that choose your asphalt textures. And it will came in here like that. In tab to edit mode, you can use the Smart UV project it. If you want, in the UV editing tab, from the left menu you can select all and rotate. We will add some snow in here, so not important for the repeated texture. In the EV, it will look like that. Under the shader again, you can unplug your displacement or delete it, because we will add some mixer in here too. For the second material, press Ctrl+Shift+T again for pressing the principal VSTF second. And as you see, it came in here with there together. From the top, we will add a color ramp and we will connect it mix shaders FAC, and you can add some noise texture in here and connect to the color ramp. With the color ramp's black note, as you see, you can mix your textures. It will look like that. You can set your values from here. With the scale, under the noise texture, we will give it like this effect. With the detail, you can add enough detail for this. With the roughness, as you see, snow is still falling and asphalt is getting covered up from the snow. It will be effect like this. For the sidewalks, we will make same thing. I speed up this part. If you want, you can go from the top right card. I showed before how to mix your textures. I am making still same thing. I'm not making any extra. If you want to learn it with detail, you can slow down this video or you can go another video on my channel. I am adding links in description. I am making same thing for the sides. I will get some render in Eevee, so in cycle it can look a bit bad. But when you get to the Eevee, we will make our render settings soon. You can add your materials. For the landscape and terrain materials, I am adding my snow material as the same method. With pressing Ctrl+Shift+T and choosing your snow textures. And after that, in tab to edit mode, you can use the Smart UV projected and choose all the terrains. Last selection material at one, you can add link material or you can add their snow to separately. For the trees, I am adding only color in here. And for the leaves, I am adding a material with only dark green color for two, because this will be night scene and we will add some snow on it. I added all trees for my materials. For the street lamp, I will add a black material in here, a bit metallic if you want. For the second material, press plus icon and press new. I will add some emission type of light. You can choose some faces in tab to edit mode. Choose these two faces and with the control numpad plus, you can choose other faces around it and assign your second material in here. Change your surface to the emission. And you can increase your strength. And our street lamps will be look like that. I'm adding for the others too. Now let's add some area lights for our scene. You can add some area lights and you can change your shape to the disc. Power up. I'm making 200 of it. You can again as the same method. I'm not making any extra or different things. You can shift it to duplicate for your scene too. Now, let's add some fog. For this, we will add a cube and we will cover up all of scene. We will add some materials for our cube. You can set it fog. Delete your principal VSDF and after that, add your principal volume. Connect volume to volume. And after that, add color ramp and connect this color to the emission strength. As you see, it's become in here. Add extra for the noise texture and you can change your color ramp's black note. And don't forget to type your density value. Which dense fog you want, you can set your scene. For the side materials, I deleted displacement and in the EV, I'm getting render. I added some landscapes for my little of scene, I scaled them and added near of my road. If you want, you can shift it to duplicate some terrain parts of it, or if you want, you can add some extra landscape for your scene. Save it, will look like that. For now, you can with H to hide the others. Go to Edit, Preferences, Add-ons and type Snow. Blender has Unreal Snow add-on in here. You can choose this with the N for the side menu. Choose your tree and add snow. As you see, it will cover up your snow like that. If you don't like, you can delete it. With the decreasing your coverage and height, you can press add snow again and it will add. I added some snow parts for my other trees. Our scene will look like that. Under the render settings, I will get this with the EV or cycle, which type you want, you can get it. In the cycle, I will get it. In the render settings, don't forget to check your motion blur. After that, go to particle and under the cache, we will bake our snow simulation in here. After your baking, you can set your frames. As you see, it will look good like that. You can get some image for render. Our snows are looking blurry because we checked our motion blur. From this GitHub page, from the It to Future, you can download some camera Shakify add-on if you want. I downloaded this zip. After download them, edit, preferences, add-ons, and you can press your install and choose your zip file from here. It will came in here and you will activate it. As you see, camera Shakify in here. And you can give some keyframes with the eye, location, rotation, scale for your camera. Go to last keyframe or middle of timeline which you want. You can walk your camera and after that press I to again add some keyframe for this. Under the camera settings, as you see, camera Shakify is in here. With the plus icon, you can set some different species from here. I choose the close up and you can increase your scale and speed from here. Which shape you want? You can set it if you want. You can add some investigation influence for the running type. After all of that, you can set your resolutions, frame rates, and choose yourself an output folder. If you want to get some FFmpeg video, you don't forget to check your encoding MPEG 4. I will get some PNG as the animation because my Blender sometimes crash. After all of that, you can press render animation and get your animation from here. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.